All right. So today I wanted to talk about becoming a confident programmer or developer. And the reason why I want to address this is because I got this question from a student recently, and I believe a lot of you are probably feeling the same way he did. Because I know for myself, when I first started, that's exactly how I felt. Okay. So in my conversation with the students, he mentioned that he doesn't feel like he's doing enough to become a developer. Okay, he doesn't feel like he's getting enough practice or he's taking on enough things to be able to call himself a developer. And he mentioned that even though he is quite excited about his new ability to create things from scratch and use his creativity to make some things that he and others can use, he doesn't feel like it's enough to call himself a developer. And then the next question he asked me was, will he become a developer after the course? And I thought that was a great question because when I first started out too, I just wanted to be able to create some big, massive projects. And I felt like whatever I was learning in school wasn't even enough for me to get to the level that I wanted to get to. So I'm going to address those two things, okay? The first one being the lack of confidence or not feeling like you can officially call yourself a developer. And the second one being whether this course or app is going to turn you into an official developer. So before I talk about that, let me ask you a question, okay? Think about your native language, okay? So your first language might be English or Portuguese or French or Hindi or whatever, okay? Think about the language that you're most confident and comfortable in right now. If I was to ask you, at what point did you learn that language? Or at what point did you learn, understand, and speak English fluently? And I asked you to tell me the specific date. So was it on day 507, or when you turned 2 years old, or 7 years old, or so forth? Yeah, think about it. At what specific point did you learn that language? See, that is a tough question because the question itself doesn't make sense. Learning English or whatever language came naturally to you through the experiences that you had, the conversations that you had, the books that you read, and so forth. Okay? It's not something that you officially became an English speaker on day 30 of your life. You're presented with a certificate saying, hey, you're now an official English speaker. In the same way, you don't reach a specific point where you become officially a developer. It's something that happens over time naturally. So, based on your coding experiences, the projects that you do, the practice that you put in, over time you become a fluent, confidence developer. And you're not going to learn everything you need to know about development. It's impossible. It's just like trying to learn each and every single word in the dictionary. By the time you get to the last page and learn the last word, by that time, another word would have popped up, another new word that you will have to learn. So, I guess what I'm trying to say is that you can call yourself a developer at any stage in your learning, but calling yourself a confident developer is another thing. Just like you can call yourself an English speaker at any point in your life, but becoming a fluent English speaker is another thing. Okay, so it's not black and white, it's there's levels to it. And you realize that when you reach a certain level, things become much easier. Okay. So for example, once you know about 800 of the most common English words or phrases, you can basically learn any new phrase or word or anything in English. Okay. Because typically, even the scholars and doctors don't use more than 1,000 words in your daily vocabulary. So for English, once you know those 800 fundamental words, everything becomes much easier. You're able to have fluent conversations here and there, but you're not logically thinking about getting to word number 800. In a similar way, in development or programming, once you know the fundamentals, everything becomes much easier. That's why they say once you know one programming language and the fundamentals behind that programming language, it becomes much easier for you to learn any new programming language. The hardest part is learning the fundamentals. Once you know the fundamentals, learning something new in programming or development doesn't become that much of a huge challenge anymore. So to answer the next question, the objective of this course or whatever I'm teaching you is to get you to that level where you know the fundamentals of programming, such as loops, lists or arrays, data structures, variables, functions. These are all the fundamentals of programming. And once you know that, you'll realize that you yourself naturally become a confident developer or programmer. So my advice to you is, instead of focusing too much or worrying too much about at what point or what stage are you going to officially become a developer or programmer, try to focus more on building various different projects, practice a lot of what you're learning, make a lot of mistakes. So making mistakes is actually a big part of building that confidence. So don't be afraid to make mistakes. And if anyone tells you that they can turn you into a confident developer within a matter of a few days, they'll be lying to you. Okay. This is something that comes with experiences. And the best way to get that experience is to experiment. Have fun with your newfound ability to code. And before you realize it, you'll naturally build up that confidence that you're looking for.